Series of an electrical and mechanical activities in the heart in one beat is known as cardiac cycle. The cardiac cycle timings are given over here. So if the heart rate is 75, the cardiac cycle time is around 0.8 second. So 75 beats upon 60 seconds. So as the heart rate increases, the cardiac cycle timing also decreases. So before going into the details, we must know the certain basics of the cardiac cycle. So the cardiac cycle followed by the excitation of the conducting system. So conducting system, as the conducting system excites, and initially atria excites, atria contracts, and then it further the excitation downs up to the apex and up to the base of the ventricles. So here the excitation and contraction of the ventricles. So here the contraction referred as a systole, relaxation referred as a diastole, and the blood always move from the high pressure to the low pressure. Here the pressures given as a high pressure 120 in the left ventricle and lowest pressure is 0, whereas 25 highest pressure in the right ventricle, minimum pressure is 0, the pressure in the atrium, and the maximum minimum pressures in the aorta, maximum minimum pressures in the pulmonary artery. So the cardiac cycle operates in two separate cycle. One is ventricle cycle, complete ventricle cycle. These are the timings of the ventricle cycle and atrial cycle. Let us start with the cardiac cycle from the atrium. So as the SA node excites, the SA node hits the complete atrial fibers and then atria contracts. As the atria excites, initially the electrical activity seen in the ECG is P wave. So the P wave indicates atrial excitation that follows the buildup of pressure in the atria. This is A curve indicates the atrial pressure over here. So here you must notice the atrial pressure is little higher than the ventricle pressure, because this time the complete ventricle under relaxation phase is around 0. So this is called the atrial systole 0.1 second timing. So after that, atria undergo diastole around 0.7 second. The timings mentioned here are completely ventricle related activity. As soon as atria finishes its excitation or contraction, the pressure drops in the atria and little bit, whereas the pressure from the ventricle starts build up. Gradually it shoots up because the excitation hitting the ventricle. Once the excitation hits the ventricle, the pressure from 0, it shoots up to the 120. This is known as isovolumetric contraction lasting around 0.05 second, where as the ventricle pressure increase from 0, so it increases, it crosses the atrial pressure, so that the valves, AV valves, has to close in order to regurgitate blood into the atrium. And at this time, the semilunar valves already in closed position, because the minimum pressure in the aorta is lying around 80 and 9 in the pulmonary arteries, because the valves are preventing the backward move of the blood as the pressure drops in the ventricle 0 in the diastole phase over here. So when the ventricle completely in diastole phase, the pressure in the great vessel aorta lies around 80, because the minimum pressure of 80 is required in the aorta in order to keep the momentum of the blood, even the ventricle in relaxation phase. So since it is no called as isovolumetric contraction, so there is no blood ejection, but whereas the pressure exceeds the ventricle prayer pressure exceeds up to the 120 and it crosses the 80, so that the pressure is sufficient enough to open the valves in the aorta and the valves in the pulmonary artery here. So this is left ventricle pressure, atrial pressure. However, right ventricle pressure is not drawn here. And we must notice one thing in the electrical activity. So before it build up the pressure in the ventricle, so it must have the excitation, that is called QRS complex. So ventricular excitation, and ventricular excitation brings the pressure up to the 120, which is exceeding the 80, which is there in the aorta. And so that's where the semilunar valves opens here and blood try to pushes in the aorta here and the pulmonary artery from the right ventricle. This is the phase known as ventricular ejection phase, the phase lasting around 0.25 seconds. So the complete phase is ventricular ejection phase. So once the blood is filled here from the atria, atrial systole, the blood is filled here. So this is the blood curve, volume curve, and during ejection the blood drops up to the 60 ml from 130. So once the ventricle finishes its contraction, so it has to relax again. So the T wave of the excitation or electrical activity indicates ventricular relaxation. So the T wave, as soon as completes the T wave, the ventricle starts its relaxation, so that the pressure drops from 120 to towards the zero. As the pressure dropping here, the pressure, once it goes below, semilunar valves closes, because in order to prevent the backflow of the blood from the great vessel into the ventricle. So the valves has to close, because the valves valvular direction is facilitating the closure of valves during the pressure drops towards zero in the ventricle in order to backflow prevention. So completely the pressure drops here. So these pressure drop, so known as the protodiastole. So the protodiastole is here, the closure of the semilunar valve of the aorta, known as protodiastole. And further the pressure drops up to the zero. So once the pressure drops zero, so that end of the phase, we can notice here the pressure of the ventricle is further down than the atrial pressure, where the AV walls get open up, because the pressure in the atria is higher than the ventricle at this stage. Blood moves into the ventricle from the atria, that is known as the first rapid filling phase, is lasting around 0.1 second. And further, the filling phase continue as a 0.2 second as a diastasis, continuous filling phase here. And the last rapid filling phase is again coincides with the atrial systole, because the last rapid filling phase already overlapped by the atrial excitation with the next impulse. And here closure of the AV walls produces the first heart sound, whereas closure of produces second heart sound. We will be discussing details of the heart sounds in the next video. So this is how the excitation followed the contractions. So the pressures of the atria and ventricle operates the volume changes, so that the cardiac cycle maintain the pumping capacity in order to meet the demands of the body.